my name is Oscar and Fire, and welcome back to Mass Effect, the Third Age Total War, you dumbass. Oh gosh, I was... Well, wow, that... Okay, so let's just get back to Mass Effect. Let's just pretend that nothing ever happened. Alright, so we just got done checking Zawin for evidence of what's-his-face's brother. Dead brother. Very dead brother. His brother's so dead. We're gonna go to the Fortuna system now. Because I don't think I've been here yet. I don't think so, anyway. We're about to find out. I may not recognize the names if I have them. Nope. Meganlis. Meganlis is a rock terrestrial with an atmosphere of sulfur dioxide and trace amounts of helium. Scans reveal ancient lava plains on the surface that play a geologically active past. The crust consists of sulfur and basalts, but the planet's mass suggests a core of iron and heavier metals. Or heavier metals, even. Cursory drill coring suggests the possibility of simple subterranean life. Therumlon is a frigid world with a thick... Thank you, voice, for that crack. Thick nitrogen-argon atmosphere. The crust consists of silicates and various unremarkable ores, but is surprisingly rich in phosphates. There's a typo there. Since the atmosphere lacks free oxygen, the phosphates are relatively pure and could be of value in the manufacture of fertilizers and incendiary ammunition. Yay. Amaranthine. Wait, have I been here? I can't remember. I think I've been to Fortuna before, haven't I? Fortuna's where I met Helena Blake, wasn't it? Yeah, I've been here before. Never mind, I remember being planets I've been to before. I forgot I went to Fortuna. Well, hold on. Let me check my journal. Because I actually think that's actually what it was. Hold on. Oh, and Citadel, where are you? Citadel, not reporter's request. Where is it? Where are we looking for the state? Citadel Family Matter, plenty of bug, old friends. It's gotta be somewhere here. We're down near UNC? Oh, hostile takeover. Yep, yeah, it was Fortuna. I didn't even realize it. Jeez. Well, I just wasted like a whole 3 minutes of this video. Great! Woohoo! I'm great. Alright. So that means you gotta go somewhere else now then. So you got Vermeia and Pharos, of course, but I'm not going there yet. Local cluster, Exodus cluster. Artemis Tau, Hades Gamma, Voyager. I don't think I'm at the Voyager yet, right? Crap, I have to check my journal again! Okay, UNC Privateers. Alright, so I got to talk to Gareth. Hawking Ada. Cerberus. Cerberus and Voyager cluster. Okay, Voyager definitely. All right, let's get to the Voyager cluster then. All right, time to stop wasting time. Time to go to Voyager. Yangtze, Amazon. Guess these are named after major rivers on Earth. Hello? Alright, there we go. Renshato! Renshato is a close orbiting hot Jupiter with traces of sulfur in its hydrogen helium atmosphere. The disruptive gravity well of the gas giant prevented any plants from forming nearby. Right, got it, okay. Binthu! Binthu is an atmosphere of carbon dioxide with a permanent haze of toxic chlorine and clouds of sulfur dioxide that periodically drop torrents of acidic rain on the surface. Why did I say acidic like that? Its crust is mainly composed of sulfur deposits of calcium. Like most worlds in the Voyager cluster, Binthu has only been charted within the last 20 years by Alliance surveyors. It has no known native ecology. Data about the world is surprisingly brief and generic, painting a picture of a pleasant and interesting place. Okay, got it. Let's check these other plants first. Dragaeir. Dragaeir is a small, barren rock world with a trace atmosphere of Krypton and Xenon. The surface is frigid and mainly composed of silicates with deposits of magnesium, aluminum, and other light metals. Dragaeir is a weak magnetic field. Weak magnetic field, I'm Ariel. What? I'm drunk, Mario. Making it unsuitable for dry discharge operations. Large deposit of beryllium, because I need more light metals. 100% need more light metals. Alrumter. Alrumter is a small, rocky, terrestrial planet with trace atmosphere of nitrogen and krypton. Its rigid surface is mainly composed of light metals and deposits... areas with deposits of frozen ammonia. What? Prothean data disk recovered. You detected a weak signal coming from the far side of the planet Alrumter. Joker brought the Normandy around and your salvage team picked up a small escape pod trapped in orbit. There is a long dead Turian site along with a few personal items and a Prothean data disk. Because apparently people just die all over the galaxy in Mass Effect. Patagiri has a thin atmosphere composed of neon and chlorine. Its frozen surface is mainly composed of silica with deposits of copper. During the long cold night, the chlorine in the atmosphere falls to the ground in the form of frost. I don't know why my brain is farting so badly right now. I'm not even that tired, all things considered. But whatever, let's go. Let's land on Binthu. Now let's show Binthu just what we're made of. Alright, we're not gonna bring Tally along if we can't recover some items because of it. We're gonna bring Garrus and we're gonna bring Kaden. There's gonna be a lot of Wang on this team today. Okay, let's see here. Alright, we are planet side. Let's see. Let's get a bit of our bearings. Ooh, look at that. It's cool. It also looks like another planet I've seen before. But that looks really cool all the same. Alright, let's see. Let's see what we got here. Alright, so we got a couple of corners where there could be things. And then there's a bunch of random crap. But nothing's in the corner. Whoa, wait, hey. I see you there. I see you there, rocks. On my sensors. Rock sensors. Good they have these rock sensors. Otherwise, I wouldn't be able to detect all these glorious rocks. I just got a face full of, Mako ass there.
Cover me.
There we go, okay. I couldn't remember how to get out for a second. It's been like a week since I played this, so I couldn't remember how to get out of the Mako for a second. Yay, heavy metals, that's what I need. Okay, let's see. Alright, so we're pretty close to that thing over there, so I guess we'll go to it. We'll go to the debris last. Okay, it looks like there's a turret coming up of some sort. Based on that large red diamond. Yep, two turrets, in fact. And, okay. My tank just fell on its ass. That's totally normal things people say. Ah! Take that heavy turret! And that heavy turret! I want to shoot this thing with my gun, with my pistol. This is normal behavior! Normal people do that, definitely. They definitely leave a tank when facing against a rocket launcher and shoot a turret. Definitely something normal people do. Oh, I have 7 points. Holy crap. I'll deal with that in a minute, though. Kaden, you have 15 points, which is why I wanted to get to you first. Let's see. Alright, let's... Oh! I didn't even realize that... Oh! I could have been using Kaden for this all along and have to keep bringing Tally along for everything. I am the worst. Forget it. Forget it. This joke isn't working. Abort the joke! Abort the joke! Let's see. First aid. And throw. Sure. Garrus Vakarion. Let's see. Sniper rifles. Let's give you Master Assassination then. Damping? Sure. We have 5 more points, so we're going to give that to you on Tactical Armor. Master Shield Boost. And then we'll save that one last point. In fact, let's re-gear the squad. Let's see. Sniper rifles, first of all. The Harpoon 7 is superior to the Equalizer 7, so let's give you that. Garrus, rail extension. see anything. What about this? Polonium 6. Okay, don't worry about any of that then. Kaden, you use pistols primarily, don't you? So let's give you the... let's give you the Razor. No, the Brawler? Razor? Razor. Yes, transfer the upgrades. Hammerhead rounds 3. My goodness, I am the worst. Should have been giving him better things already. Let's get him proton rounds. Improved sighting 3. Man, I am the worst. I have not upgraded anything of Kaden's in a century and a half, clearly. Let's give you rail extension, and let's give you that. All right. And Garrus. Oh, yeah, you need a new rifle too, Garrus. Let's give you the Kovalyov 7. Is it Kovalyov? Wait, what does Ashley have? I'd rather give Ashley Kovalyov. Then again, actually, this is more... I think, like, the Breaker performance-wise would be marginally better than Kovalyov. So let's give this one to Garrus. Yes, transfer your upgrades. Hammerhead rounds 3. Good lord, I am terrible. All right, Incendiary 6 then. Combat 5. Combat Scanner 5. And Rail Ascension 5. All right, so there we go. That's all the important guns.
I think we're good, Shepard.
Good. So we're saving here. So that we don't die. And then have to start all over again from the beginning of this episode, because I'm pretty sure that's where we would start. And then we get to boop the door. No. Oh, jeez. I thought that was a person. That was like some sort of person bending over weirdly, like some sort of pervert. Okay, there's gonna be enemies through this door. So, Kaden, Garrus, follow my lead. Hello?
Go, go, go!
What?
Go, go, go!
Where? Oh, gosh. Hey, hey, hey! Oh, gosh. Hey there, buddy! Bye! What? Kaden, get up! Kaden's so lazy sometimes. Alright. That was unique. There are things inside. Oh! What are those? They look like four-legged little thing. You know, I'm not gonna finish this joke because this joke is gonna get really crude really fast. Which means you could probably guess what I was about to say. Oh, Jesus Christ! Oh, gosh! Oh!
You must die.
Kaden, get up, you idiot! Where's Kaden? Okay, oh. Kaden. It's okay, buddy. It's okay, Kaden. You can get up now. The bad men are gone.
Diagnosis. Looks like Cerberus has other bases on this world, Shepard.
Yeah, obviously. Alright. Kaden, get up. Get up, you lazy son of a gun. Kaden. Oh, shut up, Kaden! You're just lying there taking a freaking nap for like half an hour there. Like, man, that was a good nap. Why am I bleeding out of the abdomen? Hello? Why can't I diagnostic here? I want a diagnostic! Man, this game is so disappointing sometimes. He's like, hey, you got a diagnostic station here. Maybe you can learn something from it. And it's like, I'm not feeling like it. I'm gonna heal Kaden while I'm thinking about it. I think about it. Do I have some sort of... Ooh, what'd I get? Crossfire 7, Cryo Explosive 7. Alright, we'll take those. Kaden, what kind of armor... Guardian 3. I don't even have new armor for him. Shoot. Let's go give him the medical interface while we're thinking about it. Gosh, he needs so much better armor. No wonder he just melted. A blade of coating... Alright, let's give you that, because it's better than what you had before, I think. Alright, let's get out of here. Let's go on to our next destination. I just feel like bacon in my helmet. Alright, let's see. Alright, let's head off into this corner. Let's see if there's anything hidden over this way. You never know. There are rather unique things hidden. There are rather unique things hidden all over the place. I am now fake French. I'm not even real French, I am fake French. There are fake things hidden all over the place. Okay. I do not know what's been up with my mood lately. But it's weird, random, and wacky, and... don't feel like there's gonna be anything over here in this corner, though. Because it's high ground, and... they like to nestle... they usually like to nestle little hidden things in, in low corners rather than high ones. Or, I mean, like, low elevation rather than high elevation. Right? Yeah. So let's show this research base what we are all about. Or not. Okay, that didn't... I didn't mean to destroy that turret, but okay. Kaden, put your gun away. Even Garrus had enough sense to keep his away because he blew up the turret at the exact right moment. Right before we went diving out of our tank, we fired one shot. You know, that's just how it works. You just... no, you got your gunner fire one shot and then he just leaps out of the commander's hatch at the top. Not that the Mako has one of those, but... I mean, that'd be kind of cool, you know? Imagine Shepard just kind of rolling around in a tank, you know? Head popped out of the, head popped out of the roof. And... I know you're here. I know you're here. But where? Oh, those are husks. Oh, boy. Rail extension 7. Ooh, kinetic stabilizer 7. Good.
Take cover!
Nope. Let's see. We're gonna let's see if we can throw both of them if I do that. And then Kaden, I want you to throw the last guy. Oh, bam. Kaden. What? Frickin' Kaden. Alright, fine. Kaden, go there. Garrus, you're probably gonna die if I could tell you to go there, but whatever. Like, Garrus, use damping on there. And Kaden, throw the technician. Garrus, you better use shield boost. Because you don't have any shields anyway. Excuse me, sir. Sir, I'm gonna have to ask you to just go away. Just. That's right. That's how you like to see. Garrus is just standing bravely in the middle of nowhere. And I'm hiding behind. That tickled. Oh, Jesus, help! Alright, Kaden, throw someone, please! Ah! Kaden, go here. And oh, jeez. Kaden, come out with your hands up or down. I don't really care where you put them. Just don't put them down your pants, you pervert. I don't know where that came from. I'm just calling everyone perverts these days. Obviously, because they are. Everyone's a pervert except Shepard. Alright, you two. Rally to me.
I'm on my way.
And let's see, let's medical station. Begin the manual override. Let's get in there. Heavy armor, light armor for Turians, heavy armor for humans. How that is the complete opposite of what I really need right now. Ooh, tsunamis. We got a bunch of tsunamis in our inventory, but yeah. I mean, really, he needs medium armor, not light armor. This game is so dumb sometimes. And I need light human armor, not heavy human armor. Or I need Kaden to gain some weight so he can better fit and shit. Fit and shit, yeah. No, fudge. Shit, fudge. No, yes! I'm running out of room as well. Okay, Omnitool, Chameleon, Biotic Amp, Unity 7. Okay. Okay, I'm running out of room, so once I'm off this planet, I'm gonna have to just dump a bunch of crap off on the shit. on the QM. Medium armor for Turians, heavy armor for Krogans. Because of course they have Krogan armor here. Because yeah, definitely. I mean, Turian armor too, I guess. But I think that the other one makes less sense than the other. All right, let's give you the Phoenix A. It's less damage protection and shields, but I can give you another upgrade, and that will help a lot. All right, Undressed Weave, we already got. So, kinetic buffer. Let's do that, and then we'll get you better armor soon, Garrus. You know, we'll get you better clothing and everything. And Garrus, Omni Tool. Let's give you the Chameleon 7 here. Oh no, a Thorian Creeper. I haven't been to the other planet. Pharos yet. I haven't been to Pharos yet. You both suck. There was no sign of Kohaku. I think I'm supposed to say not Kohaku. Kohaku. He must be one of the labs.
What kind of genetic mutant Cerberus has been cooking up at the next base?
I don't know. What kind of genetic mutants has Cerberus been cooking up at the next base? You tell me, Garrus. Not really, Garrus. If you're the one who has all the bright ideas of what Cerberus is up to, then yeah, I'm all ears. Take all. Why do they all have cheap crap in here? They're just filling my inventory with cheap crap. No worry though. Shit. I hit the wrong key anyway. Shit. Alright, fine. We'll override it. And gosh, it's all just junk gear. It's all the Phoenix gear and the Unity gear. And all the gear that you really can't get much good use out of. Hopefully we won't run out of room though before we get to the, before we finish the final research station. Because I really don't want to run out of room. I want to be able to take my stuff with me. Take it with me. All right, where's the? Oh, there it is. Okay, where's the truck? Garrus, where did you park the truck? Oh, you parked it, Commander. There we go. All right. I mean, the first thing I do when I get into the Mako is drive into something. I'm smart. Let's go to the top of this elevation. Hey, look at that. Rocks. Rocks on the radar. Good thing our radar is set to detect rocks. Certainly the best use of military radar ever. Oh, gosh. The Mako's like a major car accident waiting to happen. Like, really, I know, like I said before, I know the Mako's mass is greatly reduced, but I just do not see how it falling from great heights sometimes does not damage it. Like, it should damage it.
On my way.
Even with low mass. You know, like, this thing should be filled with dents, you know, Garrus, you know, like, his head should be, like, thrust through the windshield from the impact suffered and stuff, or something. Something else horrific like that. Because apparently I'm just a big fan of horrific traffic accidents. Alright, what is this point over here? Before we get to Rocket Base Delta or whatever, Gamma, or something. Took them both out, so I don't have to worry about them. Oh, hi. It's one of these. It's one of these ruins. Let's see here. Let's see what we can find at the top of this. Besides a workout. Prothean Pyramid. Alright. Woo! That was a hell of a workout. Jeez. Prothean Data is recovered. There are a few children's toys and some ragged clothes stuck inside the top of this monument, along with the Prothean Data Disc. Because that makes sense! Definitely would stuff some children's toys inside the top of a pyramid. I mean, it's just like someone just like, hey, this thing unscrews, let's just shove shit in here! Let's not shove anything important necessarily in here. Let's just shove random, the most random crap we could find into the top of this pyramid. It's not like it's... This is definitely not a bad waste of space at all. Also, I need to get Garrus some better armor. He's wearing pink and white, and it looks hilarious and awful. Alright. Hello? Housekeeping? No, I've already used the housekeeping joke a million times. This is the health inspector! No, it's just gonna make him hostile, damn it. Can't win. Alright, pistol, Karpov 7, laser 7, laser, Leos. No, new, take all. I just realized I can reduce to Omnigel when I'm picking things up. I could have done that for all the crap. In fact, you know, let me do it for all the crap right now. Where's all that crap? Where's all that crap? Yeah, I don't need that. Yeah, convert that to Omnigel. And that, and it'll teach a Striker 3 a lesson too while we're at it. And about this Avenger 4, we don't need that. Piece of junk. Let's see. Oh, not that. Wow, I got a lot of special rounds. And we'll reduce you to Omnigel. Because you were always mean to me, too. Mr. Hammerhead rounds. We don't need these Unity amps. We don't need any of these Unity amps. So we're going to save the most expensive ones for later. Alright, that should be enough to get me through the, this should be enough to get me through this. Let's beat the door. Oh, Rachni Warriors. Oh boy. Look forward to that. Aha! I knew I would lure you out into the open, you fool! In the open, yes! Throw that. You damping there on the technician. And Kaden, you use... Actually, you use Neural Shock on the things I throw. Whoa, bye! Oh gosh, that one was just hanging up on the wall. Just like, oh shit. Kaden, Kaden! Ah! I just sent a flying up into the air. Not where I meant to stick. What? Who's puking over there? Let's see. Alright, Kaden, throw! Kaden! Kaden! Kaden? Kaden? Kaden is useless. And you wonder why I'm not gonna let you be the beer. Oh, G-Mon-Min! G-Mon-Min, that's what I meant to say! And Kaden wonders why I'm not gonna let him be the Veermeyer survivor. Not that he would know about that yet. Hello? There's someone left in here, I know there is.
I'm on.
Alright, there we go. Alright, look, there's a dead body in there. It looks like he's dressed in Alliance Navy dress blues. I'm sure it's definitely not Admiral Kahoku. You check for a pulse, but find none. Admiral Kahoku is dead. Despite the ferocity of the creatures he was sealed in with, there are no signs of trauma on his corpse. The needle marks on his arm suggest a different means of execution. So why did they shove him in here if they executed him already? That seems kind of pointless. He was a good man. And a very fearful one at the end of his days. How does that sound? Oh, refrigerator. Alright, so we have one last stop to make. Where's that? Hold on. Yeah, Hades dogs. You found Koku dead in one of their bases, now you're the only one who can stop them. Head to Nepheron, the Columbia system of the Voyager cluster, and destroy it. Wait, how did I find that data? Where did it come from? Did I just like pull it out from behind the ear of Admiral Kahoku? It's like, one last thing, Shepard! Take that data disk that I shoved behind my ear, where the enemy never found it, and destroy their main base. It's kind of funny, actually, when you think about it, how Cerberus was just kind of a one-off villain group in this game. They kind of just rise to prominence as like a third major galactic power by Mass Effect 3. Like a major galactic power, I should even say. Well, they're not really major, but they aren't quite minor either. Like fall in that weird, like kind of muddled middle ground of powers where you're not really like a major player, but you're capable of influencing events. I'm trying to think actually of a country that would really like make that would actually fit the bill for that. You know, like not quite a major player, but not a minor one either. Like maybe Italy in World War II. I begin manual bypass. Come on. Yes! Alright! We made it, and I didn't cock it up this time. Shield modulator for armor, yay. Alright, take it all. Alright. We have to avenge... return to Normandy, yes. Because we have to avenge Admiral Kahoku by going to the other system in this sector. But first, I need to see the QM, because my inventory is full of junk that I don't even know where the junk is. It's not the right place. I need to go to the elevator. With my weird loping jog. It doesn't really look like I'm actually walking normally, because I don't know why I jog like this. You know, it's like... I guess I am jogging in hindsight, so I guess that actually does make sense. Never mind, I lied. I am complete liar. I am deceiver. I am destroyer of worlds. Oh-ho. Okay, where am I? Excuse me, QM! I'm gonna need
looking for supplies.
Yes!
Let's see what you've got.
You bet, Commander.
I want to sell crap. Light Armor Corbion, Colossus 8. Ooh, that's really good for Tally. I kind of want to get it. That's Phoenix. No one wants Phoenix armor except stupid people. Armageddon 8 is actually better than my Tornado. Huh. Well, let's see though. This is better than everything, so. I haven't barely been using my shotgun anyway, so maybe I shouldn't even think about it. Sell! Okay, let's start selling things. Shotgun, Storm 1. Why'd I have a Storm 1? Oh, whatever. Let's just sell all the crap up to tier 6, I think. Let's just sell everything with Reckless Abandon up to tier 6. Like, I gotta get rid of some really useful items, but I'm gonna get some new items sooner or later, so... I don't think it's a huge loss to get rid of a lot of that junk. I have so many tier 6 items, why? Okay, so let's start selling some of this crap then. Let's not sell everything. Like, let's keep like the stuff that might be marginally useful if I remember. Like some of their strengths. I don't really remember any of their strengths, who am I kidding? Okay, let's just do that. Let's get rid of these. Let's get rid of these. Let's get rid of all this. Let's get rid of all this. When we go to face Cerberus, they will not know what hit them, because we are gonna have the emptiest pockets in all of the Attican Traverse. We are gonna have the emptiest pockets, and they are just not going to know what hit them. All right, let's go back to buy, because we can now get that armor for Tally. All right. Spectre Master Gear. Should I get this? Since I never use my shotgun. Let me get it and let me be proud of my loadout. Let's just go in here. Let's go to the shotguns and let's get the Hmuzge 7. I know it's an abbreviation. Shut up. Near around 7. Alright, Combat Scanner 6. Kinect Stabilizer 7. There we go. Alright. Now we got the nice fancy shotgun, and we're gonna go back upstairs. We're gonna slam this elevator button as hard as we possibly can, and we are going to avenge Admiral Kahoku. As soon as we get back upstairs. Of all the doors not to automatically open, the ones to the bridge, you'd think would be So the CIC even would be the ones you think would open automatically for me. You know, it's just like, oh no, we're in an emergency situation. I better hit the door button. And I was just busy taking a crap in my quarters. Actually, where do I take a crap anyway? Because I remember that this does not explicitly have a bathroom, so... This Normandy does not explicitly have a restroom, so... Let's go to the Amazon system first before we go to Columbia. Why Columbia anyway? I'm sure there's better rivers. Nile, maybe? Agbinium! Agbinium is a small terrestrial world with an extremely thin atmosphere of carbon dioxide and krypton. While a planet of sufficient mass to maintain a much thicker atmosphere, much of it has been blasted away. The red giant Amazon is a long period variable star, currently at the nadir of its 16-year cycle. Sounds familiar. I've been here before. A lot of these seem very familiar. And I seem to remember mispronouncing a lot of them. Have I already been to the Voyager Cluster? Or did I go to the Voyager Cluster before Admiral Kahoka gave me the mission? Yeah, I think I've been to the Amazon system before. Because all of this seems super familiar. Because I seem to remember mispronouncing Synedma before. And Dranuka. I feel like 100% like I've been here before. Like, I'm gonna land here, but I think I've been here before. Like, gonna check the map. Alright, Rex and Liara, why not? The cutest and the least cute members of my team. You know, I also seem to remember being bathed in red, but I can't remember if there was one or two plants like this. Like, there's like two plants that you're bathed in blue, basically. Oh yeah, it looks all familiar. Oh yeah, I've been here before. Man, I didn't even realize I was here before. Ah, let's go back to Normandy. Alright, everybody. I thought I'd explore this, but I, as your commander, have made a terrible, awful mistake, and I have wasted all of our times and our fuel. All right, onward to Columbia. Yes. And bam. Clogia. Okay. Clogia is a hothouse terrestrial world with a dense atmosphere of nitrogen and sulfur dioxide. The surface is scorching hot and mainly composed of iron with deposits of gold. The core of Clogia is very hot and tectonically active. Volcanic eruptions are common, and outgassing continues to add to the density of the atmosphere. The largest active volcano is a caldera nearly 100 kilometers in diameter, and its basal floods have covered an area roughly the size of the Earth continent of Australia. That doesn't sound terrible at all. Is there anything in this asteroid field? I gotta check the asteroid fields now. Because of two asteroid fields, it feels like they'd hide something in one of them. Right? Maybe? Doesn't seem like it, actually. Doesn't look like it, huh? Surprise, there's nothing hidden there. Nepheron. Nepheron is a barren volcano. I thought it said bizarre. Volcanic terrestrial world with an atmosphere of carbon dioxide and krypton. Its surface is mainly composed of sodium deposits of magnesium. Aside from displays of geological beauty, including many spectacular volcanoes, this barren world is of little interest. Entries relating to Nepheron and its astronomical database are sparse. I shall be back after I have checked the other two planets. Onto Heater or something. It's an unusually large ice world that's core silicate rock and light metals and a trace atmosphere of krypton and xenon. The crust is mainly composed of water ice. Onto heaters, ice sheets show obvious signs of large-scale fracture and refreezing centered on a massive crater near the South Pole. A recent extranet meme suggests that Prothean's ship crashed through the crust of the planet before the collapse of their empire, and might still be recovered from the planetary core. There's a purportedly source of the planet's unusually high mass. Careful mapping on a Hatred's gravity field by orbiting satellites have proved that the planetary core is entirely normal. Alright, survey! Rare elements, samarium. Alright. Now we go to Gromar. Gromar is a rocky terrestrial world with a trace atmosphere of krypton and xenon. The frozen surface is mainly composed of copper deposits of calcium. Part of the Alliance's expedition into the expansion of the Voyager cluster, Gromar hosted one half of a Turian interferometric telescopic array. Connected with similar telescope in the Attic and Beta cluster by an expensive chain of FTL-COM buoys, the two function as a single virtual lens with an effective aperture equal to the thousands of light years between them. The Turians use this to chart determinate systems with great accuracy. Alright, survey. Medallion recovered. Scans of the planet Gromar revealed derelict space station in the late stages of orbital decay. A small team was able to recover some items of interest, among them a League of One medallion. Alright, let's do this. Let's go to Nepheron and let's avenge Admiral Kohoku. That poor son of a bitch. Let's bring Caden again, because we brought Caden for the last one. Let's bring Ashley. Let's do this. It's a human problem, so it's gonna take humans to fix it. As hilariously as humanly possible. That was very humanocentric of me to say. But I don't care. Why did the Mako turn totally black at that angle? Can we get that again? I want to see the totally black Mako again. Alright, Ashley! Don't got better armor for you, unfortunately. You got one of the best guns we can get, though. Shredder 7. Let's see. Rail Extension 7. Yeah, let's give you that. Actually, let's check Ashley's stats, because I don't know how much she needs leveling. Okay, she needs lots of leveling. So let's give her Master Immunity. Let's give her... Okay, we already maxed out her assault rifle, really, so let's give her... No, not first aid. So let's give her this. And then we kind of need to get that. We need to get that unlocked, don't we? Alright, save. New save. Now let's check the map, finally. Alright. Okay, so there. That's... Okay, they're there. So we're going to do a wide sweep. First to the north. There's already some rocks... Rock scanners are already picking up some large rocks on the surface of the planet. A planet made up entirely of rocks. They're just gonna caterpillar our way up this mountain. But that's definitely what normal people do. Rather than trying to find the path of least resistance, they just say screw it and bolt and barrel through regardless of the resistance. You good? Thorium! Alright, let's get this thorium out of the ground. Let's just... Oh, shoot! Like, please stop pressing me against this rock! This is not fair to me! Assignments. Valuable minerals, anyway. Still need a lot of heavy metals, and I still need a light metal. League medallions. Okay, need two more of those, and only one more ID tag. Wait, did we already get whatchamacallit? Yeah, we got the Asari writings already, and we already got the Turian emblems. Cool. Nice. Didn't realize that. And help. Mako go drunk. Or Mako go home. Alright, let's see what we can find. Out here. In the wilderness. This feels cold. That Earl's is chilly in this room for the first time in like 3 months. And I'm just like seeing a cold planet is making me feel cold when I'm already cold. So it's just exacerbating the cold. Alright, let's see. Okay, we're kinda sorta driving straight. Kinda sorta maybe. Definitely not. Well, I just went all the way down that hill when I didn't really want to. So we're gonna go up the path of least resistance here. And then we're gonna drive straight forward, please, according to where my camera is. And okay, there we go. Oh man, this thing is such a pain to drive. Oh geez, we're way closer to the center of the map than I thought we would have been. Well, I guess this is our course now. This is our lot in life. and that did not go well. This is awful. I keep skipping like right and left and turning. It's like a song or a dance. Alright, what's down here? Mummified Solarian. Oh boy. I can't wait to shove my hands up his sphincter to find out if he's got a League of One medallion. See, that's the implication of this minigame. Obviously, the center of that is, you know, is... Anyway. The Cerberus this isn't a Cerberus soldier. This is a mummified had an identification tag for Captain Varsinth, one of the Solarian soldiers responsible for capturing League of One. It is unclear how he came into possession of this relic. That clearly said mummified Solarian, and this is clearly a mummified Solarian! This game is dumb. This game makes no sense. Alright. Let's get back in our tank. No. Let's continue on our course. Because our course is set, and our objective is clear. Murder. Murder most foul. I don't see an underground facility here. All I see is a box and a crashed vehicle of some sort.
Cover me.
Oh, I can go in. Okay. Proton, okay, take all. Alright, hard decryption for this crate. Oops, shit. Shit. Just blew my opportunity there. I just grabbed those since I'm at it. Alright, let's see what happened over here. Oh, Jesus Christ! Oh! Oh, I went the opposite direction I thought I did. Oh, that scared me. Oh, I hate Thresher Maw so much. I should have known this was a Thresher site too, because it just looked like one. Oh, but my heart, jeez. Oh wait, don't get too close. Keep it driving, keep it driving. Oh, I'm too close, I'm too close. I missed. I'll defeat this Thresher Maw yet. Oh, it's not. Thresher Maw's over there. Got it. Got it. 37,200. Little money dues. All right. Let's see. Is there anything on this crashed little vehicle here? Nope. Nothing at all. But I guess you know what happened to the inhabitants of this little place. They got mauled. They got threshed. Basically, they got murdered. All right. Let's go. Let's go to the actual place I thought I was going, but it really didn't. Nothing like killing Thresher Maws with long-range shotgun blasts, too. Nothing more satisfying than using a gun for anything other than its intended purpose. Also, we gotta kick northeast a bit. Didn't realize I was going too far south. Okay, there we go. In fact, I have... Sensors are picking up life forms. They're probably filthy Cerberus agents. Yep, yes they are. Including snipers. That hit my shield. And now you're melted, sir. Or ma'am. Dear sir or madam. Well. Cerberus anti-tank? What a silly man. Bye. He burned to death. Thank you, Ash. What would I have you around for if not to tell me the obvious? Alright. Equipment. Katana 7, Katana 7, Crossfire 7, Punisher 7. Alright. So we are clearly in the 7s now. Alright, let's save to Nepheron. And let's finish this. This sound just weirded out. Alright, let's finish this. For Admiral Kahoku. Okay, great. What is that? Great, there's a bunch of cut stone slabs and like looks like concrete tubing in here. Great. I'm really glad. I'm really glad there's just a bunch of that kind of stuff here. No, you won't. Oh, gee! Freaking Ash! Alright, Caden, throw! Ashley? What's going on? Well, this isn't good. Alright, Ashley, use overkill. Caden. I'm gonna throw that guy. I just shot Caden in the back. We're being flanked! We know, you've had your shield. Your shields have been down. Gonna lift you up so you're not a nuisance. Oh shit! Oh, Caden's down. I don't know what's happening. Gotta switch my pistol. Do I throw? Yes, I do. Go! Cover my back. My 6, even. You're more at my like 4, but whatever. Go! Oh, Nikes! Caden, why are you useless? Hi. Hello, sir. There we go. Oh, jeez! I thought I was gonna stick there. I'm gonna use Unity so Caden doesn't spend the entire... He's dead. Good job, Caden. You actually did something useful today.
All targets down.
Good. And Caden, you did absolutely nothing in that fight. You should be ashamed of yourself. Just like everyone else should be ashamed of you. And especially for that thing you did with Liara the other day. You know, dragging her in to talk about our relationship. Rather than letting her grieve for her mother. Caden's such a fool. Such a self-centered fool. And I, for one, can't wait till I sacrifice his life to blow up a bomb. Okay, let's take that. Get that. There's a lot of equipment in here. Ooh, I barely avoided that. Armageddon 7. 8, even. Not 7, 8. In the manual override. No! I got too greedy. Shit. Got it. Karpov 7. Game manual override. Alright, let's... Oh! Got! There you go. Clear spot. Alright. Take all that. Now I think about it. Equipment. That's a lot of junk. Combat Scanner 7, though. I guess I can use that. Because you know what? It just occurred to me I can upgrade everyone's weapons and not have to worry a thing about it. Alright, Tsunami 7. Let's give you the Avalanche 7. Alright, do you... You have the best pistol I could give you, right? Ooh, the Karpov has slightly better damage, actually. Let's give you the Karpov. Yeah. Alright, and let's give you the... Naginata 7. What is this? It's just a 7. The 7-7. 7. Alright, let's see. Let's give you a better sniper rifle. Naginata 7. You know you don't really need any of this. Brawler 7. Armageddon. I'm actually starting to pronounce Armageddon wrong because I have too much fun pronouncing it wrong to begin with. Alright, let's see. Anything else? That's not what I meant to hit! Alright, medic. No, begin manual override. Why did it make it sound like it was starting when I obviously wasn't? Light armor, Quarian, Phoenix 8. Oh boy! A thing I'm never going to use because it's junk! Polonium rounds and incendiary ammo. There's a lot of stuff in here. Who's in here? What's going on? 8 station. Terminal. Anything else in here? No? Alright. You cautiously press a few buttons and an alarm chimes. The optical database is flashing itself. Quickly, you copy as many files as you can to your hard suit's internal computer. Its memory wipe, the computer shuts down. The files are sure to be encrypted, but you've got time to crack them. Alright, well, we got it. We've shut down Cerberus, it looks like. Right? I'm keeping my gun out just in case. I think I'm okay. Huh? Alright, so... That server has taken down. It took an entire episode. Holy jeez. I want to thank you all for watching this episode. If you enjoyed it, leave a like and a comment down below. Be sure to subscribe for more. Also, check the links in the description below for links to my Twitter and Facebook pages. An extra like 2016. And I hope to catch you next time because, frankly, there will be a next time. Admiral Kahoku may be avenged. But there's going to be a lot more avenging that needs doing. And I'll be damned if Commander Shepard won't be doing it. Until next time, everybody. What are you doing down here, sir? Sir, what are you doing? Sir, what are you... What, you think you're gonna trick the enemy by just being on the flank? You're gonna be like, oh, I'm being creative. I'm trying to trick them. I'm such a clever Sassy Sue. That Bannerman just stabbed a dwarf to death with an axe. That is badass. Arrows really be raining down on